choir and orchestra will now perform a few patriotic songs.
The thing is that it gives you a confidence. Not only that, it teaches you how to live away from home. Because before that, I was born and raised on a farm, knew nothing about how to take care of myself. I didn't know how to sew buttons on shirts, so at least I had one advantage. The thing is, you marched from your barracks to the chow hall to your classes. Yes, you did go to school in basic training because you had to learn the different rules and regulations of military. We marched to the obstacle course, the rifle range, and I might add too, one of the nice things about the Air Force is I fired a rifle once, and that was to qualify. You know, you hear about all the other branches of the service, you have to train on your different weapon systems and everything. Not me. After I got out of basic training, I was sent to Lowry Air Force Base in Denver, Colorado. You know, you wake up in the morning, you see the beautiful Rocky Mountains in the distance, and sometimes you see the snow and everything falling while it's nice and sunny in Denver. At that point, my electronics training did pay off because the specialty that I went into was nuclear weapons. But to get into that school, I had to go to school another 6 weeks to learn the electronics the Air Force way. After that, then we went into nuclear weapons training. You learned how to tear them down, how to fix them, even learned how to spray paint. Now you think it's interesting, but the thing is weapons and any other equipment in the military has to be done, number one, by a specific color, and it has to be done in a certain way. So, you know, you learn how to spray gun, and then also with the tools and everything. I was originally supposed to be sent to Norfolk, Virginia, but they decided to send me to Germany. Now, the thing is with nuclear weapons is the fact that also I was in a military, in a missile system over there. As I tell people, I spent 26 months, 60 feet underground, babysitting four nuclear tipped cruise missiles. I knew what my targets were, but even to this day, I will not disclose them. I know things about nuclear weapons, the same thing. One of the things is, you know, you're talking 50 something years. You don't forget it. Being a veteran is not a 1, 2, 3, 4 year program. It's something that stays with you your lifetime. You know, at various times through my life, okay, I knew I was in the Air Force and everything like that. The thing is that subconsciously it stays with you. And one of the things too is like, we meet down at the VFW when we go to military funerals. When you get a bunch of veterans together, now I might say we've got Army, Navy, Air Force, and Marines as a cohesive unit to do military funerals. The thing is we harass each other because each branch of the service fights. And I don't care what branch of the service is, but it's bantered, but in a good way. But when we become a unit to service others, we become a cohesive unit. The other thing too is that what people don't understand is civilians do not understand how that works. But in case of trouble, it's like anything else. We as military are ready to serve even today. We are ready to be called up because when we take that oath is we are to defend our enemy, both domestic and foreign. So, I mean, we stay with that. And it's good because the other thing is you build up a relationship among people. You know, when you're service, you know, like on a missile system, there were seven of us on a crew from different ways of life. Some of them were lifetime members and some of them were just like 4 year members. But you become a cohesive unit. You learn how to work together. And that's what you've got to learn to do, even in school. It's like study together. Sometimes somebody will come up with an idea like, hey, this is how we solve a problem. This is what we've got to do. We've got to understand what America is about. We've got to understand our patriotism because, you know, we are the best country in the world. Sometimes we don't think so, but you look at some of the troubles around the world. We are the best country in the world. We have so much more to give each other. The thing is, as a military unit, if we don't have a good military, how are we going to defend ourselves against our foreign enemies? So we have to develop a military, we have to enjoy it. And the only thing I regret is not staying in 20 years. And anybody that joins the service, I encourage them to, because really, it's not a bad life. They give you 3 meals a day, they give you uniforms, they teach you a trade, because even like aircraft engine mechanics, when they get out of the service, you can go to work for any airline. Like myself, was the field that I was in is really not that much. But the thing is, it taught me how to work together, how to do things efficiently. And that's what you've got to learn how to do, how to become a unit, how to be proud of your country, and how to study and plan your future, because now is a good time to set yourself for your future. Enjoy yourselves, enjoy your grade school and any other school. Don't do like a lot of us do, it's like, oh boy, I can't wait to get out. Enjoy it, be part of it, be involved, and be together. Thank you very much.
Thank you, Mr. Brenner, for those enlightening words. And on behalf of the Helbert Park family, we sincerely appreciate you and all the veterans for your service. Let's give them one more round of applause. God Bless America, that will be performed by the Helbert Park Choir.
We will be singing the chorus 3 times, and the third time we ask that you sing it with us. I think most people probably know this, and we ask that you sing the last time with us.
Thank you. like to recognize recognition of the armed services. What we're going to do is just pass the mic. So if you'll please introduce yourself, the branch of the military you are in, and also your years of service, and the student that you're here with. We greatly appreciate that.
Al Nett, U.S. Navy, 1966 to 70. I'm here with my grandson, Harrison Gorman. Bernie Schaefer, United States Air Force. I can relate to every minute that you talked about. I appreciate that. I did the same trip. I'm here with Jared Bolikoff, that tall, skinny guy back there.
Navy, 66 to 70. I'm here with my grandson, Ethan, and my granddaughter, Lainey, and Noah.
I'm Ezekiel Townsend. I'm here for Caleb Townsend back there in the choir. Joined up last year in the Navy, and that's about it. Bonnie Townsend, United States Marine Corps, 1982 to 1986, United States Army, 1987 to 1995. I'm here for Caleb Townsend.
I'm Joseph Green, U.S. Air Force, 2016 to present, and I got about 17 more years. I'm here with little sister Leah Green.
I'm Robert Hayes. It's my grandson, Luke Moore. I put 20 years in, 1960. I graduated from Wright's High School. I appreciate everything. Thank you.
Here's my niece.
I served from 2005 to 2011.
My name is Rick Gregory. I served in the Navy from 72 to 74. I'm here with my granddaughter, Addison.
Hi, I'm Jay Chandler, retired Army Colonel, 36 years of active duty, and I'm here with Ed.
I'm Tom Reed. I was in the Air Force from 67 to 71. I'm here with my grandson, Gavin.
Kim Lindenberg, United States Army National Guard.
Thank you.
Thank you, TJ and Lucy, for that presentation of TAPS. Let's give our performers and veterans a warm round of applause. Into dismissal, and we will head out with sixth grade heading out at this time through those doors.